touching me! I can take care of myself.
What have you done?
What have you done?! You started all of this! You ruined us!
Ruined us? Phoenix, I saved us.
You killed Weltrin!
And by doing that, I made you realize there is no such thing as hope.
You destroyed hope! Don't walk away from me! Don't do what you do all the time! When you turn your back and abandon those who you love!
I don't love you! I don't love any of you. I don't love anyone. I'm done with you.
Hatrix.
Stop it!
We're a team, remember?
No. No, we're not. We never were, we never will be. Snap out of it, Phoenix. The sooner you do, the sooner you'll realize that you're on your own. And you always have been.
What about the lost boys?
They'll always be lost.
Kendon?
Catrix is right. Goodbye, Phoenix Merritt. House Allura.
Sparrow.
Words.
Rise above. House Windmar.
Three spears.
Words.
Words are weapons. House Sheeran.
Red-tailed hawk.
Words.
Honor conquers vengeance. House Falcon.
A golden fox.
Words.
Screw whores, get gold.
Pretty sure that's wrong.
Pretty sure that's 100% right. Louder than thunder. Funny how an idiot gets such a noble title.
I know. Revan Sheeran, High Lord of Ravensdale, King of the Northerlands.
King Lalit Falcon of Elkir.
If you're destined for the crown, it belongs to you.
He'll drown our house in our own blood.
Better learn how to swim. You're King of the Northerlands. We should be doing something more than memorizing house words under a tree. Up for a little adventure, Lord Sheeran?
Royce says I need to be responsible.
You're a king. Responsibility comes with the job. But trouble? You have to make it yourself.
Gallows!
Behold the mighty Revan Sheeran, King of the Northerlands, the first of his name, who cowers in the face of danger and would rather focus on being responsible. Ooh, tremble before him.
Oh, shut up.
Why don't you make me, my lord?
Royce counts the swords 100 times over. He'll notice if I take one.
Don't you get it, Revan? Ravensdale belongs to you. The castle, the servants, the knights, the swords. These are yours. So, take one.
Yes.
What are you doing in here? You're not getting a sword.
And why can't I have one?
You're only a little filly.
I'm not a little filly!
Funny you chose this one.
Why?
It's Revan's name day present.
So he gets a sword? He's younger than I am!
He's going to be 13. A stallion. Every stallion needs a sword.
And how about me? Why can't I have one?
Okay, Vanshi, let's make a deal. On your 13th name day, I'll get you a sword.
Really?
Yes, really.
Do you promise?
Yes, Vanshi. I promise.
What's wrong?
This one. For a room?
I'm looking for a resident here.
By the name of?
Variot Winmar.
I'm afraid I can't help you, m'lady.
I know he's here. I need to speak to him. It's urgent.
Go home, Lady Avidian. Northerners don't look that kindly in Birdport. Warrenvale has a bone to pick with your brother.
Then go speak to him.
Speaking to him never went anywhere. Maybe I can find a way to send him a message.
Lord Everin wouldn't appreciate any harm done to his sister. Nor would I. My lady. Djorfane is known as the Grinner. He takes prisoners from the north and keeps them in Warrenvale. He sits there, cheeks to their ears, whenever the northerners don't do as he says. He's after your daughter.
Well, we have to get her out of Birdport. It is not safe for her here.
Avanchi. Your children are very desirable. They want to take away what makes you strong.
Like how King Altair took away my son. Sir Winmar, if any harm is going to come to Katana, I want you to tell me now.
I swear to you, I will always protect your daughter. You have my word.
Did you give your sister word that you would protect her husband?
My sister will never be deserving of my word.
How is she, Katana?
Unhappy.
I just want her to be safe, Sir Winmar.
Your daughter never will be safe, my lady. Every horse in the kingdom will tear at your children until they are nothing but piles of
bones and pools of blood.
And you'll fall beside them if you don't keep my daughter safe. I would like to see my daughter before I return home.
I can arrange for that.
How does the Grinner plan to find a Banshee?
He has his ways of finding who he wants.
She has her ways of not being found.
Long time since I've seen your ugly face, Ilion.
Too long, Sir Windmar.
Sir Windmar? Looks like traveling has gained you some formality.
Mighty Shadow Brigade. How sweet.
They've been recruited from every kingdom, from the High Islands down towards the Northerlands and Baelor.
It's said that Northerland stallions fight like fillies. How many of your knights come from the High Islands, Sir Scythe? Coat of Gold? House Menteth?
Yes, Your Grace.
And you, House Hutch? Any knights from Baelor?
Aye, Your Grace.
Real knights come from Baelor.
Yes, Your Grace, if I do say so myself.
The rest of you must be northerners, yes? Where are you from? Undergage. And you, Rosewood.
We're from Lower Ravensdale, Your Grace.
Undergage. Cute little things you've collected, Sir Scythe.
They're strong fighters.
May I test that? Cute little tool you have there. Teach me how to use it. Well fought. I'm just not warmed up.
Of course, Your Grace.
I'm done here, Uncle.
My name is Luca. I am the Golden Prince. Every horse wants to kill me because I'm the Golden Prince? This just doesn't make any sense.
Luca? The sun will set soon. We need to start moving.
Of course. I just need a minute. Fensha? What makes me so important? Why am I so different than any other horse? Why am I the Golden Prince?
Because of your father, of course. The King of Alkyr, protector of the realm.
The what?
Oh, Luca, you're only a colt. It seems the Golden Prince isn't the strong and noble horse we believed.
I suppose not.
It all began many, many moons ago, while King Agrius Gaudiel was the ruler of the kingdoms. King Agrius believed in strengthening his bloodlines and having a long lineage. He had 5 daughters and 5 sons. When the eldest princess came of age, she was meant to be mated to Altair Falcon, who at the time was the heir to Dark Front. The morning of their mating, the mare was found with her head severed off and her body hanging in her closet. After the death of his eldest daughter, the second daughter was to prepare to mate to Altar. At the mating, her drink was poisoned and she asphyxiated before each one of her family members, pawing at her throat for breath. Despite the failed attempts to be mated to the Gardiel daughters, Altair demanded the third daughter, refusing to believe that there was something wrong with the situation and that the murders were simply a coincidence. The mating night of the third daughter, she went missing and was later found, her body suspended from the highest balcony, hung. Agrius was furious and wanted revenge for the murder of his three daughters, so he sent off his two eldest sons to locate the murderer and bring him back to Black's Vale. The son then located a stallion who they believed to be the killer, but on the night of his execution, he had escaped his cell and Agrius's two sons were found hanging from the rafters of the cell. Frantic and paranoid, King Agrius hid his remaining children in the highest keep of the castle, out of harm's reach, and told the kingdoms that his children had been murdered, all but one. He knew he needed an heir, so he selected his son Jelrim to rule over the kingdoms if he were to pass. Many moons passed, and King Agrius soon went mad, slaughtering his living children in the keep out of fear, and ultimately throwing himself from the castle and ending his own life. As Jelrim grew older, he had two children, a colt and a filly. By this time, Altair Falcon had become the High Lord of Darkfront and was desperately searching for a mate. Jelrim promised him his only daughter, Styria, but on their mating night, she was found hung. Jelrim, fearing that the curse had returned, took his only living son and hid him in the keep his father had once kept his children. Altair Falcon, furious that he had been cheated by the Gardiels once again, waged war and overthrew the throne, claiming it as his own and killing Jelrim in the process. Jelrim's remaining foal was found in the keep and was instantly ordered to be executed so that House Gardiel had no more claims to the throne and their bloodlines were forever erased, though the foal managed to escape. The foal was identifiable by his unmistakable golden glow of his colt, a trait that only Gardiel foals carried. The king offered a reward to anyone who could bring him the head of the prince, and many horses killed foals at random, bringing them in and claiming them to be him, though the coat of the foal could not be matched. The Castiels were only one house who went mad attempting to find the foal, bargaining with the falcons until they were promised piles of gold for his head. Others, such as the Everins of Green Isles, wanted to protect the young foal, hoping one day he would be found and take back the throne from the falcons. For moons and moons, the foal has never been sighted. Until now. Luca, you are Jelrim's remaining foal. You are the Golden Prince.
I'm no king.
You are the king.
Avalon, I'm so sorry. I will never let anyone do this to you again. Don't be afraid. I'm here to help you. I know I've done wrong in the past, but we must come together again. You're my sister and I love you. Avalon? No! No. 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 Avila?
Father!
How's my princess?
Tired of being a princess.
You don't have to be a princess any longer. You're coming home.
It is best. You broke my son's heart. You will pay.
Thank you.
You said you would try. You said we could have a family! You made a deal with House Gelric! We were going to rule together!
I do not want to rule!
Avila, silence!
She belongs to me, my lord.
She is not a possession.
Then why did you trade her away to me? Why did you trade away your daughter? She never loved me. It's because she loves you.
She doesn't love you because you're a monster.
Oh yes, of course. This whole time, seducing my mate, turning her into one of you. It was you all along. Flowers suit you, m'lady. Don't think for a second I didn't hear everything you spoke of. You tricked her into thinking that you loved her, but I know the truth.
And what truth is that?
You don't love her because love doesn't exist.
Vera, please!
You wouldn't do it. God knows Lord Tarashi Shirin would never kill such an innocent cult. To that, I say do it. Kill me. You have taken your daughter, my queen, so you might as well take my life along with her. Am I going to have to beg you to do it, Lord Shirin? Will I have to get on my knees and beg for the mighty Warden of the North to stab me through the neck and end it all? You've taken my queen, and along with her, you're taking my child. She said no. She cried and she pleaded and she screamed for me to not touch her. She has too much respect to Mother Foles at such a young age. I didn't care at all. I took your little girl and I threw her against a table and I knocked her out cold. Lifeless for those moments, I didn't care. I raped your daughter in that very spot and I enjoyed it all the same. You're going to let me live after what I've done to her, Lord Shirin? You're going to let this heartless villain live on to take another queen and do it all again? Or maybe if you let me live, I'll come back. I'll come back and I'll put another fall in her, or slit her throat instead for all the trouble she's caused me. So what's it going to be? Your daughter's life? Or the life of the monster who put that child into her against her own will?
If he said, help me kill the president, I'd say he was very sick. See him screaming, let us in. The wire's got the best of him. All that he invested in goes straight to hell, straight to hell. Whoa, 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 whoa. Straight to hell, straight to hell. Whoa, 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 whoa.
We talked about making it. I'm sorry that-